might be a little tight at this weight. If he is in this heat, it's problems.
Yes, he weighed 9 stone, 1 pound in his last fight.
Away they go, it's due to go 12 rounds. IBF World Bantamweight Championship, Orlando Canizales the champion in the blue trunks. Britain's Billy Hardy from Sunderland in the red. Canizales, a real good boxer, fighter. And what a scrap they had in Sunderland. If we get anything like that here, it is going to be a real treat. Hardy with a little knot of about 40 fans, some of them wearing Sunderland football shirts, shouting for him, but they're completely outshouted by this big crowd from Laredo, who are all right behind Canizales. So tough to win away from home. Hardy gets him with the first significant shot, a good right to the head there, behind his jab, and then goes down to the body. Hardy's the kind of fighter who's paid his dues in this business. He's not the product of hype or silly publicity. He's a good, solid, no-nonsense pro, and he will not, I don't think, be intimidated by this atmosphere. He's fought away before in Italy. That's quite an experience, too. Good left to the body there from Canizales. Hardy gets him with his right over the top. Quite a confident-looking start from the British boxer, Colin.
Yes, but of course it's very, very early days yet. But he looks unworried. Just getting on with his work.
Very, very hot here. The temperature here at 4:10 in the afternoon in that ring, we reckon, is over 100 degrees under the television arc lights.
Rena's not put too fine a point on it, Ian. If Hardy pulls this off, this will be the greatest British away win since Lloyd Hannigan beat Don Curry to win the world welterweight title 5 years ago in Atlantic City.
Good first round. There's a good right from Canizales. Hardy just knocked back in the ropes, but comes back and wants to go and trade with the champion just to show that he's not intimidated. Doesn't want to let Canizales grab any kind of initiative here. He wants to stay with him. Canizales, who in his other world title fights, apart from the one against Hardy, has stopped everybody. The first Hardy fight was certainly his toughest defense. Oh, that's a good right. Left jab, then a right from Hardy. A little bit of blood just by the nose, just a hint of it, nothing serious at all. On the beak of Hardy's nose. Interesting first round, and it's a great title fight we've got here. Rejoin us in just a second.
In the heart of the beautiful English countryside lies the famous...
Thank you for a great job, Bill Benton, Lester Bedford.
Welcome back to Laredo, IBF World Bantamweight Championship fight. Britain's Billy Hardy starting off quite well in the first round against champion Orlando Canizales, who comes from right here in Laredo, Texas. Second round, it's due to go 12. Canizales, blue trunks, Hardy, red. Canizales is very, very experienced now. He's still only 25, but he's had a lot of fights, nearly 30 now. Hardy, just a couple more. Hardy, who's been the British bantamweight champion for 4.5 years and through 4 defences. He's proved himself the best in Britain. Can he be the best in the world? There's a good right from Canizales. Hardy took the punch well. But a few danger signals were flashing there for the challenger.
Yeah, Canizales is making his mark pretty early on. Hardy knows he's around already. That was a very good punch. And it caught him with a good right hand in the first round too. He's got very fast hands, Canizales.
And he's quite good too. You see the way he can fight on the retreat like that as well. Just skip out of range, slip punches, close quarters like that, and counter straight away with that left hook. It only hit Hardy's gloves that time. You know, very smart boxer.
He doesn't waste a shot either, Ian. You know, when he lets one go, it's usually on target. 2 lefts went in there.
Just one thing, though, when Canizales fought Hardy in Sunderland, Canizales did become increasingly easier to hit as the contest wore on.
Yes, well, unfortunately I missed that one because I was away in the States at the Foreman-Cooney fight.
Oh, that's another thunderous right, and that buckled the knees of Hardy, and he's in a bit of trouble now. Really big punch, and this is really dangerous for Hardy now. He's got to get the gloves up and cover up and somehow get through the rest of this round. The second big right from the champion. And these are nasty moments now for Hardy.
I wish British fighters didn't have so much pride. He should have gone down from that punch just to get his head clear. But his pride just wouldn't let him.
Big round for the champion. Crowd are on their feet. They sense that their man is going to give them the home win. And Hardy here is having a nasty second round. And he's going to need all his conditioning. And at the moment, he's getting out-punched, out-boxed. But this is what the training's about. All the conditioning, all that work in South Africa, all the road work. He's got to somehow use all his experience to get through this crisis. He's caught by a left uppercut this time. Hardy needs the bell. Last few seconds of the second round. And the bell cannot come quick enough for Sunderland's Billy Hardy. A bell goes to end it. There's another right and a left after the bell from Hardy. Crowd didn't like that. But they cheer to the echo. And Hardy also has a cut by the side of the left eye.
How do you feel?
Well,
all right. Don't look for one big shot.
Keep hiding running to the right.
There's that right. There was that right that really buckled Billy Hardy. He did well to stay on his feet from that. You could hear the voice of Jesse Reed in Canizales' corner. Don't look for one big shot. Bad round for Billy Hardy, and to make it worse, he's got the cut, Colin.
Yeah, he's in all kinds of trouble. In actual fact, as I said before, if only it had gone on the floor, take the momentum away from Canizales and allow his head to clear.
Play for the crowd, son.
Those 3 minutes here must have sounded, must have felt like 30 minutes to Billy.
Well, in the Canizales corner, Jesse Reed was saying, play for the crowd, show them every trick you've got. So they want Canizales not only to win this fight, but to put on a show as well. Hardy with grease by the left eye. Terrible crisis for him in round two. If he can come through this and somehow get a foothold back in this fight, it really is going to be some effort. But everything is against him in there at the moment. He's having to show tremendous mental character, apart from anything else. He's scored again.
Yes, he seems to be a sucker for that right hand over the top of his left leg.
Right to the body this time from Canizales. Hardy tries to out-jump him and then elbows him away. No holds barred. Canizales just took that, comes back with a clubbing right. The cut is reopened by the side of Hardy's eye. I think that's all right, because I think the blood is going to not run into the eye. But again, the left hook this time. There's just too much variety, too much hand speed about Canizales' work for Hardy at the moment. Then the right over the top. It's a terrific performance from the champion so far.
Well, he's looking $1 million here in front of his hometown fans. There's nothing like fighting at home, as Billy Hardy will tell you. I mean, Billy very nearly won that fight in Sunderland because he had the backing of his home crowd and his usual environment.
Well, this third round is not quite as bad as the second. He's trying to stand and trade with him, but the punches are bouncing off Canizales' chin, and Billy Hardy is not a bad puncher. To the left hook, rolls him over, and I would be surprised if he can get up from this one. Well, he's on one knee. He's up. The count will go on to 8. But, well, Billy Hardy's brave challenge could be about to end here. And still, he needs to cover up. He needs to get away from the champion. Canizales piles on the pressure, rams home the punches, pours home the punishment. Trying to work behind his jab, and Canizales is walking through that with some really meaty shots. Hardy, if he can, if there is a way back into this fight, and I doubt it. Oh, he scored again. Really big right. How did Hardy take it? His eyes went into orbit as that landed, Colin.
Yes, it's. I'm afraid that if the referee doesn't stop it, maybe Dennis Mancini will pull Hardy out of this, because it's turning into a bit of a massacre. And I don't like to see one-sided fights.
He's getting, I'm afraid, a beating in here at the moment, Billy Hardy. Really was a thunderous right from Canizales. I thought Hardy was going to be, well, lights out, really, but somehow he stood up, lands a left right at the end of that, goes back to the corner. Now the referee's having a word with him, Bob Gonzalez. I think he asked him, are you okay?
Well, he probably gave him a bit of a going over for just the second time he's hit Canizales after the bell. So he probably read him the riot act as well. But if the referee's got any compassion, he wouldn't have been too hard on Billy. He stood in there, he stood up to some tremendous blows. Watch that one. My heavens. How did he stand up to that?
Goodness only knows.
He shouldn't have done again. He should go down, you see. Give him a chance.
Ladies and gentlemen, what a great day of
that was the left hook that did put him down, and he did a somersault as he turned over. I thought he wouldn't get up from that one.
Promoter Cedric Kushner, ladies and gentlemen. Cedric Kushner.
Well, he always did need a miracle to win here. He needs two miracles now.
Well, we hate to be the people who bring you doom and gloom, but it's hard to see anything that's very optimistic so far. As they go into the fourth round, you're just watching that knockdown again at the end of round three. Well, can Hardy somehow find a toehold back into this? But it's been brilliant, Canizales, the first three rounds. I don't think there's a bantamweight in the world, really, who could live with this. Of course, the IBF is just one version of the title.
Well, certainly not in Orlando in this heat when you come from Europe.
This is the fourth round. Hardy's done very well to get this far. He's caught with another right and took it again. It bounced off his chin that time. But somehow he's got to start slipping those. Easy for me to say, much harder for him to do. Colin Hart was mentioning the Alamo earlier on, up the road from here. Well, it must feel like the Alamo for Billy Hardy in there at the moment.
Yeah, he needs John Wayne and Clint Eastwood come to his rescue.
Canizales just dodging this way and that. Good lateral movement from him, looking for another angle. Well, and that right hand's been a jackpot punch for him so far.
Yeah, and Billy's more or less saying to Canizales, if you're going to beat me, you're going to nail me to those boards.
Fourth round, due to go 12. Suffocating heat here. Everybody with fans, parasols, drinks. Fancy having to fight in this.
And of course, yeah, when you're taking punishment like Hardy's taken, it saps your strength and your will, your desire.
But Billy Hardy, I know, wants this World Bantamweight Championship so very badly. And I think Colin's right, Canizales is probably going to have to nail him to the canvas. Another left hook this time. Again, Hardy takes the punch well and shows tremendous resilience. Still poking out his jab. But he just hasn't been able to shake up Canizales at all with his own punches. Now Canizales gets to work to the body with left hooks. Great variety of Hardy's work. Super hand speed. Hardy took those on the elbows and gloves. Got his gloves up well. That was better from Billy defensively. Canizales, whose brother, Gabby, is the deputy sheriff here and also the WBO champion at this weight. I don't think those two will be meeting in the ring. Again, a good left there. It's a slightly better round that for Hardy. At the end of that, the fourth round. Back with temperatures close to 100 degrees out of the ring and over 100 in the ring under the light for the fighters. I don't remember it being as hot as this since Barry McGuigan went to Vegas and challenged Steve Cruz, or sorry, defended against Steve Cruz's featherweight championship, lost it, of course, and Colin Jones fought Mil McCrory for the welterweight title in about 100 in Las Vegas. It's that hard. Billy Hardy's acclimatized well, but Canizales has really looked a class act here. Blue Trunks Canizales, Red Hardy from Great Britain, world bantamweight title fight, round five. Getting to the stage of the contest, or towards the stage anyway, where the heat might become a factor. They start to get drained. Hardy trying to find a way back into it. He's been down once. He's a long way behind already. Again, those combinations thud home from Canizales.
It just shows you how super fit. It just shows you how super fit Hardy is. I mean, he's in magnificent condition, otherwise he wouldn't still be in there from the punches he's taken. Maybe it's a good thing that Canizales has been headhunting him rather than going to the body. That could be a good thing, but I think boxing people will know what I mean.
I know they'll all be watching this back home in Sunderland and hoping that somehow Billy Hardy can pull this off. Before the fight, he was talking to me. He says, send them all my regards. I'll be fighting for them in there. Chants of Hardy, Hardy coming up bravely from those little 40 or so Sunderland fans.
You know, there's no doubt, Ian, that Canizales has slowed appreciably from those first four rounds. He's not quite got the zip he had early on. You never know, maybe he's so tight at the weight that a long fight would do him a lot of harm. That's why he went out so quickly to try and finish it.
Hardy's having his best round since the first here. Canizales is throwing so many combinations. On the move, presenting the mobile target, just content to poke out his jab. Denny Mancini in Hardy's corner, his manager shouting to him. Denny, who's been around the game 31 years and has never managed a world champion. He'd love to do it, but it looks odds against here. But I've seen fights swing around before, and it could happen in this heat. Hardy is just hanging on in there, coming back quite well in this round, scoring with his jab. In fact, he's throwing more of the leather in this round, Colin.
Yes, because Canizales has definitely slowed. And Hardy is now beginning to pick him off. But he keeps walking into that right, although it doesn't seem to have quite the same effect as it had earlier on.
Still Hardy trying to come forward. There's the end of the round. It wasn't a bad round for Hardy. Again, he would...
You deserve to be grappled.
You're looking at Gabby Canizales there, the WBO bantamweight champion in the corner of his brother Orlando. Gabby 5 years older. He goes back there. We're telling Canizales to throw more to the body between the rounds. This is round six of the world bantamweight title fight, IBF version. Champion Orlando Canizales in the blue trunks, and Britain's Billy Hardy in the red.
It was the left hook to the body from Canizales that put Hardy on the floor in their first fight. I think it was the ninth round, I believe.
And if Billy Hardy has ever looked vulnerable in his career, it's been against body shots, although it was a head punch that put him down here, left hook. Walked onto a ramrod jab of Canizales there, Hardy. Good combinations to the head from Hardy this time, left and right.
Yes, and you notice that Canizales is standing still now.
And the jab from Hardy this time. And that Canizales does land that left hook to the body that they told him about. He's a good learner, this fellow, his trainers say. Now he ups the pace again. I think he's trying to pace this, Canizales. He doesn't want to punch himself out. Maybe why he took it a little easier in that last round and Billy Hardy just came back a little bit more, but when he moves into gear, Canizales really does look a million dollars. Good hooks inside, then the uppercut inside from Hardy. Nice work from him. Then the jab, three times. Hardy starting to put his punches together now, just starting to grow in confidence. After those torrid second and third rounds, it's been a pretty good comeback, this, from the British bantamweight champion. And now Canizales digs those hooks home to the body this time.
Hardy's absolutely brilliant the way he's come back from what looked certainly beat a couple of rounds ago.
Oh, punch out, punch out!
Heroic effort away from home. And the left hook. Hardy coming forward now. Getting caught. Oh, he's caught though. Hardy's caught with the left hook himself. Now he's in reverse gear. Wants to get off those ropes. Does. Canizales is a nice fellow, but he's got a kind of cocky, arrogant way about him. He never thinks he's going to be beaten.
As that applies to all the great champions, Ian. They've got to have that touch of arrogance.
Hardy coming forward, forcing Canizales back. Now, is there just a little nick by one of Canizales' eyes? Try to tell you when we get a closer look. It may have been an illusion. As, again, right this time from Hardy. Hardy really here is starting to get quite confident at the end of the round. That was a good round for Billy Hardy. He goes back to the corner. There is Orlando Canizales. And we could still have a fight on here. Join us again in a second.
Nice and alert, nice and alert.
You're looking at a replay.
You're in control.
Well, it wasn't really at that speed. Not in this seat, they couldn't do that. That is the American feed that we're getting, television feed. So sorry about that little technical hitch. But what it would have shown you at normal speed is that Hardy had a very good sixth round, and Colin Hart and I both gave it to him on our scorecards. First round I've given to Billy so far. Hardy, red trunks. Canizales, blue. This is the seventh round, and Colin, this heat, well, this could be a factor now.
Well, it is. If Canizales has had trouble at the weight, it'll be a big factor in Hardy's favour and might annul all the work that Canizales did early on, because he's still way, way behind on points, Billy. He lost those rounds early on, very big indeed. I made him lose 1-10-8 and the knockdown round 10-7.
So he's 4 or 5 points behind, like being 4 or 5 rounds behind. That's how we have it at the moment. In the seventh, Hardy trying to get back into it. Canizales hasn't let go any of those big concussive right hands in the last couple of rounds. Hardy's getting his left up better now, and he comes in with a right of his own, then a left hook. Canizales shakes his head as if to say, no, that didn't hurt me, but it was a good shot.
You notice now how Canizales is banged up against the ropes and can't get off. He's lying there resting.
And of course, if Canizales has had weight problems, it's getting to the point where it just might tell. We can't confirm it, but we do know on the day of the weigh-in he was 3 pounds over in the morning and hit it right on the 8-stone-6 limit later on. But of course, he's had a day to get over all that under the current modern rules. If he'd have weighed in on the day of the fight, it might really have been a factor. Good right from Canizales there.
Yeah, but it didn't move in that time. It didn't move Hardy like they were doing early on. There's no doubt that all the snap has gone out of Canizales' work.
And the crowd have just gone noticeably a little quieter. Not quite so exuberant as they were early on. There's just a sense around here that the issue is not quite over yet.
Could this be another Hannigan curry?
Hardy just ramming home the jab, but they're single punches and he really wants to start throwing them in combinations. Little nick by the right eye of Billy Hardy and some swelling by the left of Canizales. His eyes have been banged up before Canizales. They were against Hardy last time. That was a good right from Hardy. He's trapping Canizales on the ropes a lot more now. The pattern of this fight has changed. And the blood throws a little bit thicker by the left eye now of Hardy too. Heads came close together. Watch the use of the elbows. Canizales motions to the referee. He does nothing. Good left hook there, though there was a hint of the inside of the glove about it from Hardy, to be honest with you. End of the round. Another pretty good one for Hardy, who's getting back into this slowly, but needs something pretty dramatic.
Shut up, sir.
In the heart of the beautiful English country.
From the weather conditions we have here, 86 degrees, the humidity at 68%. It really is very humid. And ringside here, which is where we are, is 100 degrees. And it's about 10 more than that if you're in the ring, because there are very hot lights shining down on the boxers for television purposes. Billy Hardy at the end of the last round gave a little knowing smile to Canizales. So he's obviously feeling a lot more confident now as they come out now for the eighth round.
Yeah, the Canizales punches don't hurt quite as much.
Of course, if this does go to the judges' scorecards, well, it's just the reality of boxing that Hardy cannot expect too many favours fighting in the other fellow's backyard. He's not going to win a close points decision here, is he? That's the reality of it, Colin.
Yeah, and quite honestly, he doesn't expect to.
The judges, for my money, a little bit lopsided. One from Texas, one from Mexico. And Britain's Roy Francis. That's a good right from Canizales, stepping it up a bit in this round. I think Canizales probably will have got to the point where he feels he needs to reassert himself, and how he's done it! Left hook, he's laid Hardy out. Cairns come in the ring, referee Bob Gonzalez waves it all over. What a shot! And Billy Hardy is knocked out in the eighth round. Now, we do not need all these people in the ring, because Hardy looks a lot the worse for wear. Let us hope he's all right. Celebrations going on in the other corner, the crowd celebrating. And Billy Hardy, just as he was beginning to come back into the fight quite well, is knocked out, and it was a peach of a punch, Colin.
Yes, no arguments. Clean as a whistle. Now, you can see Billy's line there. He's quite away. He's talking, he's saying, I'm all right. But very wisely, they'll keep him lying there for some time to make sure he recovered fully.